I suspect all car owners can relate to this story. Everyone's gotten a bad parking ticket or two. But $105,000?
The World According to Jon.
Hello and welcome to The World According to Jon. My name is, as you know, Jonathan Paula, and today we're going to talk about Jennifer Fitzgerald, a poor, unemployed woman from Chicago who now owes that city $105,761.80 in outstanding parking fines. And if you're wondering to yourself, how does that even happen? Let me explain. Her now ex-boyfriend, Brand Prouveau, bought a 1999 Chevy Monte Carlo off Jennifer's uncle for $600. He paid all the registration and title fees associated with owning a car, but did so in Jennifer's name, meaning that she is on the hook for all these outstanding fines. Brand is an employee of United Airlines at O'Hare International Airport, where he parked the car in 2009, and then he just abandoned it there in a secured airport parking lot. And for some reason, it never got towed, even though out of the 678 tickets received were everything between being in hazardous and dilapidated condition, having no city sticker, broken headlights, missing or cracked windows, expired plates, being an abandoned vehicle, and most importantly, in violation of parking a vehicle for more than 30 days in a city-owned lot. All of these things racked up and gave Jennifer more than $100,000 in parking fines, but for some reason, the city never towed it away. At least not until just last month. After 3 years went by, Jennifer finally got one small step ahead in her legal battle. She has filed a lawsuit. She's trying to get the registration moved back over to her ex-boyfriend. She's trying to get the plates removed so the tickets don't go to her. And she's just trying to fight the whole case itself, which is like, I shouldn't be getting any of these tickets because after 30 days, that should have been impounded, that should have been towed away, and anything after that date, I shouldn't have to be responsible for. And she has a great case. None of this stuff makes any sense because the car was registered without her knowledge. It was long overdue to be towed and impounded out of that lot, and yet the city just kept giving it tickets, sometimes as many as 7 in a single day. I want to see what the windshield looked like on this thing. It's a joke that the Chicago City Traffic Authority, or whoever does this, would just sit there and just keep giving it orange tickets and not even think twice about, you know, maybe this is an abandoned vehicle, and you know what? Maybe nobody owns it. Maybe no one's ever going to pay for it. Because in all likelihood, after this case finally goes to court next May, it's probably just going to be destroyed and no one's going to pay for the car. So I feel like the city is unrealistic to expect anyone to pay it. They're unrealistic to keep issuing it tickets. And if the ex-boyfriend did all of this as like a really vicious, like, get back at her prank, like, hey, I'm going to buy a car, register it in your name, and then abandon it somewhere so you have to pay all the fees. Like, one, that is a really ingenious prank. Except for the fact that you just stiffed your ex-girlfriend and the mother of your child for $100,000 when she's unemployed. Like, I don't care what she did to you, but that's kind of a dick move. Even if she's only on the hook for like a fraction of that, that's a dick move. This is a ridiculous story. I don't even know how this stuff happens, but that's your weird news for today, and it'll have to do it for this video. So please let me know what you think about this story in the comments down below. But for now, that is The World According to Me. My name is John. Thank you for watching and listening. I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.